Let's get Zoom installed on your computer. To begin, in a web browser, navigate to the Zoom Download Center at zoom.us/download, then click to download the latest Zoom desktop client. From your downloads bar or folder, click to open the installer once it has finished downloading. A dialog box will appear outlining install steps and options, but most users can simply proceed with the default options. Before you can finish the installation, you might need to enter the computer administrator's name and password. On a personal device, you might not even see this, but if you do, and you don't happen to know this information, reach out to your organization's IT department for assistance. Once installed, launch the Zoom desktop client. Now, if you are in a pinch and need to join a meeting right now, simply click Join a Meeting and enter the meeting's ID number and password if there is one. Otherwise, click Sign In and log into Zoom using either your email and password or one of the single sign-on or SSO options below. SSO is typically used by large companies or organizations, and you would probably already know if this applies to you. Once you are signed in, you will arrive at the Home section. Buttons to initiate a new meeting, join an existing meeting, schedule a meeting, or share your screen are front and center. Sections for various Zoom products and features are found along the top. If any of these added features or products aren't visible to you, they might be disabled by your organization's account administrator, or you don't have a license for that product assigned to you. Should you want to reorder these sections, simply click and drag to sort them as you see fit. From time to time, you'll need to update the Zoom desktop client to gain access to the latest features and functionality. When an update is available, a notification banner will appear across the top of your home page, allowing you to click and initiate an update. You can also click your profile icon and choose Check for Updates. Note that updating the application will cause Zoom to restart, so you should avoid doing this while doing something important, such as hosting a meeting. To automate the update process, navigate to the application's settings and check the box to automatically keep the client up to date. You can now create, connect, and collaborate with others using Zoom.